Hello guys, Barry here. Today I'll show you how to remix the zipline in Apex Legends. Pathfinder's zipline gun will be in the later video. Before I started to make it with Unreal Engine 5.1, I did some research in the game and found out that the zipline is quite different from the other games. For some ziplines, you can only take it from one side to the other side, and they are always one way. But in Apex, you can take it at any position when you get close enough to it, and it will show a tip when you can take a ride. In Apex, you can jump out of a zipline when you are in the process of moving, so you can jump directly to another zipline even you have been moving on a zipline. Zipline system is quite flexible, so I will try my best to remix this. The last point, because it is a competitive FPS, it requires you to be able to shoot while moving. So we will did some tricks with which is different from the other tutorials on the internet. There are some other less important details that we will get to later. Let's start by looking at the assets needed. First, we need a honing animation. A zipline sound effect. The shooting sound effect will be used in the next video. A zipline mesh and two overlay materials for the ghost state. A dust particle effect. In this video, we mainly use three blueprints, a character, a wedge, and an actor. The wedge is a simple tape text, which I set to be desired on screen, and you can adjust its size as you wish. Then there's the zipline blueprint, which has the zipline component. The mesh component is set to zipline rod with no collection. That one is used for cable component as its child, which also has no collection. Collection of spline mesh component will be used as collection to interact with the player. I used a slider that comes with the engine and set its collection to overlap or dynamic. 3x scaling is fine for me. Add a wedged component. Use the wedged BP just now as a wedge class. Set a size to 1000. Check draw at desired size. The size component was set to default, and I'll talk about what it does later. The last one is the audio component. Let's place the sound of moving on the zipline. Next, you need to create 8 new variables. Add a new update cable event. We will use this event to update the location of the cable. Here you need to add a socket for the Zipline rod. Let's open the mesh. Select the socket manager from the window. Add a socket to it. Adjust the location and save. Let's go back to the blueprint. Set the location of the point with index 0 and 1 on spline to the location of socket on start and end. Add another event, interactive zone. Get number of spline point, -2. For each loop, get location and tangent at spline point with correct index, and index +1. Set mesh start and end with the locations and tangents. Connect to event begin play. On component begin overlap of spline mesh. Cast it to the BP Pathfinder. Let's open the Pathfinder blueprint. For this video, we only need 2 variables, the Zipline blueprint and the B writing. I remove the spring boom and attach the follow camera to the mesh. When we press the E key and the writing is false, valid gets the correct Zipline. If it can write, call the writing event and play the honing animation montage. Remove the default jumping functions. If spacebar released, stop jumping. If it is pressed, check the writing variable. Choose call the stop writing event or Zipline. False call jumping event. Limited duration. I'll see you in the next video. Don't forget to subscribe and like. The next video will be coming soon.